From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. A standoff in the Riverton section of Portland ended peacefully after six long hours on Friday. One by one, six suspects, five men and one woman, surrendered to police after Portland's special reaction team surrounded an apartment at 2 Pinewood Road at Riverton Park. They negotiated with the people inside, trying to talk them out. Police responded there about 7 a.m. after a woman said she was jumped and her cell phone was stolen. The woman had cuts to her hands and police had reason to believe there were weapons inside.
We believe we had firearms in the residence, and we're concerned for the citizens as well as our police officers. So we're not ever going to just rush into a situation without doing everything the correct way. And if that means that it takes a little extra time and people are inconvenienced, I think the long-term goal is to make sure that they're safe.
Police say no guns were found inside the apartment, and Friday evening they released the names of six people in custody: Hassan Osman, Biniam Segai, Hassan Akubar, Samantha Pecoraro, and Mohammed Saeed are charged with disorderly conduct and failure to submit to arrest or detention. Samadi Mohammed Hassan is charged with criminal threatening and with a dangerous weapon, criminal threatening, aggravated assault, and violations of conditions of bail. It may have failed to pass in the state legislature, but they're not bowing out of this fight. That was the message Friday from some involved in a plan to build a racino in York County. Biddeford City officials held a media conference today to say they're not giving up on a proposal to move Scarborough Downs to Biddeford and to add slot machines. Earlier this week, the state Senate narrowly rejected a bill that would have allowed the move, but because it was a citizen initiative, it will go to voters in November.
Last week is that we're in it to win it. We're not giving up. We're having to do it the hard way, but we have so much commitment and we know that this is a good thing for the whole state of Maine.
A public relations representative for Scarborough Downs and developer Ocean Properties says those groups have stepped back to consider their options, namely deciding whether or not to pursue the racino. Governor LePage signed a couple of bills into law expanding gambling as well as the sale of fireworks in Maine. One of the bills legalizes the sale and use of consumer fireworks. The bill, which includes a number of restrictions, won't be law in time for this July 4th holiday. In fact, it doesn't take effect until the first of next year. The second bill permits an expansion of gaming at the Hollywood Slots Racino in Bangor. If local voters also approve, table games will also be allowed at Hollywood Slots.
There should be 14 tables or so in there, and we think it'll make Bangor a more complete destination. So rather than just come for slots machines and go on to other places for other games, they'll now be able to come here, have a full panoply of games, and do other things in town.
Governor LePage is calling the just completed legislative session a success, but he says there are still some very serious issues that need to be addressed. Energy costs and welfare top that list. Thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.